আসসালামু আলাইকুম ওয়া রাহমাতুল্লাহি ওয়া বারাকাতুহু। আলহামদুলিল্লাহ, অল প্রেজ ইজ টু আল্লাহ সুবহানাহু ওয়া তাআলা দ্যাট হিয়ার উই আর টুডে অন দিস নিউ ইসলামিক মান্থ, দ্য মান্থ অফ জুমাদ আল আখিরা। এন্ড অ্যাজ উই আর ইন দিস মান্থ, রিমেম্বার ইয়াউমুল জুমআ, দিস ফ্রাইডে, we thank Almighty Allah Ta'ala that we are able to offer our Jum'ah prayer, because those masajid have taken the initiative. They have exhausted all their avenues to ensure that they are able to keep the masajid open. What a great blessing and ni'mah it is. And as an imam there at the Pearly Masjid, alhamdulillah, our trustees have really worked with our volunteer team to ensure that our masjid remains open. So alhamdulillah, when the government have even allowed us to keep our places of worship open, then really it is the responsibility of duty of those who are running the house of Allah, those who are in that position, and those who are the many part of the management or the trustees. They have to exhaust every single avenue to ensure that their masajid remain open. This is the time where people need to come closer to Almighty Allah Ta'ala. When we look at it from a logical perspective and we see that people are able to go to many different places because of, they said these are the essentials and these are the requirements and the needs. Remember, even more so, we need to have a connection and our attachment to the house of Allah. If the masajid are following the government guidelines and they are taking all of the precautionary measures, and the musallis are following the guidelines and bringing their own prayer mats, and even they are wearing the face mask and alhamdulillah keeping their distance, then what is the need to have our masajid closed? It is more important when you have such great blessing and ni'mah, the house of Allah. Wasta'inu bis sabri was salah. This is the time that we need to have sabr. This is the time that we need more salah in praise in our life. So one of the handiworks, one of the mission, one of the aims of the shaitan, there are those like the month of Ramadan. We said, how do you prepare for the month of Ramadan? Because Ramadan comes as a time where people come closer to Allah because they understand the value, the virtue, the importance of the fasting. They understand the importance of standing at night in prayer and searching for the night of Laylatul Qadr. So there will be those that were not praying and they will now come to the masjid and they are turning to Allah because they want their sins to be forgiven. Here we are witnessing every day and we are learning and listening so much so that, it's more important to have a deeper connection. It's like Allah is giving us a chance that we turn to Him, we pray to Him, we ask and we make tawbah and istighfar. But the shaitan, he wants us to adaa'u salat. فَخَلَفَ مِنْ بَعْدِمْ خَلْفٌ أَضَاعُ الصَّلَاةِ وَاتَّبَعُ الشَّهُوَاتِ فَصَوْفَ يَلْقَوْنَ غَيَّا. How many a times we are visiting the graves, but yet we see the heart is still hardened. And that is where we have our iman. When we say, what is exactly the iman? Is it sufficient just to say amanna? Is it sufficient to say la ilaha illallah? To have that belief is really crucial, important. But remember, qawlun bil lisan. Your statement, La ilaha illallah, Muhammad Rasulullah. Is it sufficient just to say the qawl and the statement? Or you have to follow it by? You have to have, yes, i'tiqadun bil qalb, because it is the condition of your heart. Because there are those whom, in the name of Islam, and they have, openly claim and say that they have beautiful Muslim name, but you will find that when it comes to amalun bil jawarih, the actions, then this is where we have to question our iman, because iman yazidu bil ta'ah wa in qusu bil ma'asiyah. It increases with obedience and it will decrease when there is disobedience. In such a time when there is a pandemic, when a people are becoming sick and contracting the virus, when a people are passing away, When a people are being rewarded the death of the shuhada, litakunu shuhada, when the condition has become such, then even more so to be and to making dua for those who are ill, those who have passed away, we have to have connection with the masjid. When I attended one of the janazah prayers, and I found so many people, you know, the guideline says, okay, 25, but then when the masjid, which is taking the responsibility for the janazah and fulfilling the rights of the deceased and the burial, if the masjid is closed and people need to have that connection with the house of Allah, then is it not making it more a challenging for those who are trying to help? And whether it is to stop the spread of the virus, is it not putting greater pressure on other masajid? So we need to understand, if you go to most of the masajid and you see our condition, and you see, including myself and every one of us, we know our weakness in our iman, that if you have your local masjid and if it is also open for the prayer, see how many of the people, even when there is no lockdown, even when your masjid was open, how many did frequent the masjid when it came for Salat al-Fajr? So now we want our condition to change, but already there are those who have and do not even go to the masjid even for Salat al-Fajr. And there are those who are put into such positions, and there are those who have that position of authority, and there are those who are trustees. You will see that there are many, many masajid whom are being run by those whom are passing, you know, as we say, they are making decisions, they are disregarding even their imam, and they are making such, you know, and they say that this is not a light decision. Think about the condition of a people, and even this is one sign of the hour. You know, when that person came to the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam, and he asked, "Mata as-sa'a?" You know, when is the hour? And he sallallahu alaihi wasallam, in the narration, one of the points that he had mentioned for the one that questioned the questioner about the hour, إِذَا ضُيِّعَتِ الْأَمَانَةِ, when that amana, when the trust and when that has been lost, then you should wait for the hour. إِذَا وُصِّدَ الْأَمْرُ إِلَىٰ غَيْرِ أَهْلِهِ فَانْتَظِرِ السَّاعَةِ, even when matters are being given or placed in the hands of those whom do not have and are not deserving of such positions, then wait for the hour. So we are in such a time, in such challenges that we are facing, that many of the masajid that have been closed down, even though they may be, or maybe there are those whom you have to say volunteers are available and they have maybe strict measures in place, and therefore the heart and the mind cannot understand what is the logic and where is the evidence behind this grave and serious decision. Yes, indeed, it is understandable if you cannot, and after having exhausted all of the avenues to try and put those strict measures in place, if that is not possible, then it is a different matter. So therefore, we are saying the default should be keep your masajid open. We need more salah in our lives. Iman al-qawlun bil-lisan, i'tiqadun bil-kalb, amalun bil-jawarih, yazidu bil-ta'ah, wa yanqusu bil-ma'asiyah. If you think about the broad definition of iman, and even when you speak about sifatu ahlil iman, the qualities of the people of iman, we say that the most high from the qualities of iman is La ilaha illallah. Wa adnaha imatatul adha anit tariq. Removing that harmful object from the way and the path is also a quality of iman. Wal haya'u shu'batu min al iman. And haya is also part of iman. Modesty is part of iman. We need to understand that Allah Ta'ala says in the Quran, Ya ayyuhal ladhina amanu, la tulhikum amwalukum wala awladukum anna zikrillah. O people of Iman, O people of Iman, Allah is addressing the people of Iman. And now the question is, what is our understanding of Iman? Because there are those, even during this time of the pandemic, even though we have so much of knowledge about the increasing number of the people that have contracted the virus, and we all are in a queue, we don't know whom may contract it, we don't know who is going to go next. Therefore, even in such a time, yet their heart is not connected to the salah and the prayer. Because how are we going to seek the help of Allah? وَاسْتَعِينُوا بِالصَّبْرِ وَالصَّلَاةِ. So we are saying, have sabr, have patience. We are seeing the people passing away. We are seeing a person. And, say, have sabr and have patience. But is it not Allah Ta'ala is saying, salah and prayers? And that is where the danger lies. That there are those who have abandoned the salah bil-kulliya. The whole family, the father, the mother, the children, there is no salah in their life. There are those, even before the masajid, those who chose to close it, they have been those who only used to go for a Jum'ah prayer. And when the masajid have even suspended Jum'ah prayer, because not making and exhausting every avenue to try and keep the masajid open, this is the default position. So what is going to be the condition of that person whom already only used to attend for a Jum'ah and Friday prayers? So now in our heart, in our mind, we're saying, we have to keep ourselves safe. We have to ensure that we are worried. We said safety first, preservation of life first. You know, whether we like it or not, a condition may come upon you, and even if it's not a virus, because Allah Ta'ala has already said, وَلَنَبْلُوَنَّكُمْ, we will definitely test you. So you may not contract the virus, but you may become sick because of other reasons. There are people dying for many, many other reasons. There are even people whom are passing away because of the delay in their appointment or whatever the reason, if there are not enough beds in the hospital to accommodate the people with other conditions. You can well imagine people are passing away for other reasons, but the believer knows and he understands that yes, indeed, life is sacred. We do whatever we can. Yes, we have to take and do the tawakkul. We have to have our reliance in Allah. But already our condition is such that our iman is so weak. And then we said have tawakkul and reliance in Allah. So therefore, understand when Almighty Allah Ta'ala is addressing the people of iman. Ya ayyuhal ladhina amanu. So what is the condition of our iman? If there is already no salah in the life of the believer, if there is already no salah in the life of our mothers and our sisters in their home, what is going to be the condition when a person is going to lose his close and dear and beloved one, when already there is no attachment to the house of Allah, when already there is the danger and the warning that has been made very clear, as I mentioned, when Ibn Mas'ud radiallahu anhu mentions, Laysa ma'na أَضَاعُوهَا بِالْكُلِّ that is تَرَكُوهَا بِالْكُلِّيَّةِ وَلَكِنْ أَخَّرُوهَا عَنْ وَقْتِهَا. When he's speaking about those who have abandoned أَضَاعُ الصَّلَاةِ, it does not necessarily mean that they have abandoned it بِالْكُلِّيَّةِ in its entirety, in totality. It also means that there are those whom have delayed the performing the prayer in its time, or they may delay the Zuhr just before the Asr, or may delay the Asr Salah and wait until just close to the Maghrib time, delaying it right until the end of the time. So bear in mind what will be the condition of that person when Allah Ta'ala is saying in the Quran, فَسَوْفَ يَلْقَوْنَ غَيَّا, they will be thrown into غَيَّا, which is a fire in Jahannam, which is a fire in hell. So therefore, understand, إِلَّا مَنْ تَابَ وَآمَنْ وَعَمِلُ. We need tawbah, we need iman, we need action. And that is what sifat of Ahlul Iman is. يَا أَيُّهَا الَّذِينَ آمَنُوا, أَوْ يُهُ بِلِيبْ, لَا تُلْهِكُمْ أَمْوَالُكُمْ وَلَا أُولَادُكُمْ عَنْ ذِكْرِ اللَّهِ. Do not let your wealth and your children turn you away from the remembrance of Allah. Understand that when we are speaking about our iman And when we said iman increases with obedience, what is the condition of in our home when there are those who have to, when there are no salah, when the children whom are supposed to be given their tarbiyah and upbringing and bringing salah in their life? Rabbi ja'alni muqima salati wa min dhurriyyati. Dua of Ibrahim Khalilullah. Make me the one that will perform the salah and my zuriyah and my offspring. This is the time and this is the reminder that just like you, neither you nor I know how conditions can change from one Jum'ah to the next Jum'ah. So therefore the believer is such. إِنَّمَا الْمُؤْمِنُونَ الَّذِينَ إِذَا ذُكِرَ اللَّهِ. When the name of Allah is mentioned, وَجِلَتْ قُلُوبُهُمْ. The heart should be trembling. وَإِذَا تُلِيَتْ عَلَيْهِمْ آيَاتُهُ زَادَتْهُمْ إِيمَانًا. And when their ayat and the verses are recited unto them, their iman is increasing. وَعَلَىٰ رَبِّهِمْ يَتَوَكَّلُونَ. And upon their Rabb they have tawakkul and reliance. So our tawakkul has become such that we are only concerned about our physical well-being. Our deen is not only that we take, we have to take care of our life and our health. Yes, indeed, our deen is also الَّذِينَ يُقِيمُونَ الصَّلَاةَ وَمِمَّا رَزَقْنَاهُمْ يُنْفِقُونَ. Those whom establish the salah. So understand that when we say what is iman, there is also sifat of Ahlul Iman, the quality of the people of Iman. So Allah Ta'ala has made it very clear. Those from the believers, when the name of Allah is mentioned, what is the condition of their hearts? When the Quran is recited, how is the condition? And here we are coming to the masajid of Allah. Look at the beauty in our prayer that we are all are standing facing towards the Qibla. We are facing in one direction. Already you see in the manner that we are worshipping Allah that you are not even, you are silent even in your prayer because you are listening to the qira'ah and the recitation of the imam. So what difficulty is there when you have to leave your home and offer your salatul fajr in jama'ah, in the house of Allah? And this is what we need at this difficult and challenging time. Man salla al-bardayn dakhala al-jannah. For those who have closed the masjid, we are saying, yes, okay, keep your masjid open for Salatul Fajr only. And you'll see the condition of the people in the locality, in the community. How many of the people will come? Is our masajid full as it should have been for Fajr, like how it is in Jum'ah prayer? So you and I, we know the condition of our heart. We know that we have weakness in our iman. And we know that iman yazidu wa yanqus. Iman will increase and iman will decrease. So we do not want to be at such a time that when the time comes, when we have to leave the dunya, that on that day that we have left the dunya, we would not have performed our prayers and salah. We are asking Allah Ta'ala for Allah mahabib ilayna al-iman. That, oh Allah, increase us in our iman. Give us love with this iman. We are praying and we are making a dua, and we just as a people, when we go and we perform and we participate in the janazah prayer and the burial, and you understand the reward even of participating in the burial, you understand the reward even of visiting a person that is sick, how challenging it is, how what a test has come upon a people, upon the ummah, upon the communities, when there is this restriction in place, that even it could be your beloved mother, your beloved father, grandfather, it could be your beloved brother. When, how do you feel when you have to isolate and you are not allowed to be at the time where we would normally love to recite Surah Yasin for your deceased, for the one that is passing away, as Rasulullah sallallahu alaihi wasallam is reported to have said, and you have to do the talqeen and say La ilaha illallah. How many of a people are leaving the dunya, and how many we don't know in what condition in some places. You will be shocked when you find a people whom have nobody else from of the family members, and when they open their eyes and there is no you know, no member of the family, and you have those as the, you know, we have the nurses and the staffs and the NHS as they are the people whom are working very hard and tireless, taking care of your beloved ones. This is the time and the challenges that we are facing. So understand, let's start by making the change and understand what is the, you know, we said, just like how we said, Iman has a definition, but then again, there is also alamat and signs of a person's Iman. Let's take this call. Assalamu alaikum.
Wa alaikum assalam, Iman Sahib. My name is Musa Bobat. I'm calling you from London. I just wanted to make inquiries that at the moment there is a coronavirus going on, and they are, the government is giving some kind of injection. Can you be able to inform me a little bit? So, are we allowed to take this sort of medications? What is the situation?
Yes, I mean, at the end of it, you know, there are many of those whom have looked and they have made their research, and at the end of it, whatever your decision you make, whatever, you know, we say, whether it has the side effects, and if it is minor or whatever, the necessity according to the person's circumstances, and as there is a lot of those that had consulted the medical professionals, and those, you know, we say, it does not go against the tawakkul and the reliance in Allah, because لِكُلِّ دَاءٍ دَوَاءٌ, for every illness there is a cure, there is a remedy. And if there is this research and those professionals, فَاسْأَلُوا أَهْلَ الذِّكْرِ إِن كُنْتُمْ لَا تَعْلَمُونَ, it is like saying an imam would not know the details about what is, and you know, the vaccination, but there are people who are the experts and the professionals, and those that we have consulted and those who have look into all of this matter in great detail. Yes, it is permissible to take these vaccines and to have the vaccination. And then it does not go against the tawakkul, because at the end of it, nobody knows. وَلَن يُؤَخِّرَ اللَّهُ نَفْسًا إِذَا جَاءَ أَجَلُهَا. Nobody, it's like saying there is something available, it may have certain side effects, and if that is the reality, but it is a means for saving a person or protecting him from contracting the virus, then it will be allowed. So therefore, bear in mind, we pray to Almighty Allah Ta'ala, just like how a person, when he goes to the doctor and he goes and he takes you know, the medication, and thereafter he turns his and has a tawakkul in Allah, because you know, people go for treatment before people become sick. And everyone, it sometimes that very same treatment, it may work for somebody, it may not work for somebody else. But generally, the principle is, yes, it will be allowed. So may Allah Ta'ala protect and make it easy for all of us. And as we were explaining about, وَمِنَ النَّاسِ مَنْ يَقُولُ آمَنَّ بِاللَّهِ وَبِالْيَوْمِ الْآخِرِ وَمَا هُمْ بِمُؤْمِنِينَ, we need to bear in mind that this topic of Iman, Sifat Ahlul Iman, end of it, you know, it's like saying, there are from amongst the people, وَمِنَ النَّاسِ whom will say آمَنَّ بِاللَّهِ, they will say they believe in the year after, and they are not mu'mineen and believers. So let's make dua that Allah Ta'ala do not turn our hearts away after He has given us Iman. You know, just like how we are concerned about our physical well-being, we have to be concerned about our mental well-being. And one of the benefits of the salah that you are performing, and when you are going for the prayers and jama'ah, you are already giving you that Iman booster. You are already, you know, it's like saying you are connecting yourself to the one whom, as you enter into the salah and prayers, you think and you understand that what you are looking and where you are, He is the one who is in control of everything that's happening in the life of this dunya. So He, our Lord, our Creator, is the one that we are going to be returning to. How many times we are reminding ourselves, and when we are in the cemeteries, and we are saying, مِنْهَا خَلَقْنَاكُمْ وَفِيهَا نُعِيدُكُمْ وَمِنْهَا نُخْرِجُكُمْ تَارَةً أُخْرَى. So we will be returning to our Creator, and therefore on the day of Yawm al-Qiyamah, when all people will be standing And yes, there will be those ما سلككم في سقر قالوا لم نكن من المصلين, from amongst the people that will be put into the saqar and the fire in Jahannam, there will be those who were not from the musallin, those that had abandoned the prayer. So let's make that concerted effort. If you are and have not been performing your prayer as you have, you know, the life is in the body and you are alive, this is the chance to turn to Allah Ta'ala with tawbah and repentance and istighfar. This is the time to really make that sincere tawbah, repentance. Don't even wait for the month of Ramadan. Don't even wait for next Jumu'ah. Yes, as we are going for the Friday and going to be in Jumu'ah, think about the beauty of this fada'il and virtue of the day of Jumu'ah. Such a great day, a day where du'as even are readily accepted, where there is an hour. Pray it and make du'a that Allah marfa'anna al-waba wal-bala. Make that du'a and turn to Allah Ta'ala with a repenting heart. Let Allah give you and me the strength and tawfiq to turn to Him with a repenting heart, to bring that salah and praise in our life, to understand that successful indeed are those whom قَدْ أَفْلَحَ الْمُؤْمِنُونَ الَّذِينَ هُمْ فِي صَلَاتِهِمْ خَاشِعُونَ. So not only they have khushu and humility and devotion in their salah, at the end of the sifat of the people of Iman is وَهُمْ عَلَى صَلَوَاتِهِمْ يُحَافِظُونَ. They are safeguarding and protecting their salawat, meaning the five daily salawat. أُولَٰئِكَ هُمُ الْوَارِثُونَ الَّذِينَ يَرِثُونَ الْفِرْدَوْسِ. They will be from those who will be the heirs of Firdaus. And that is where we all and what we are striving for. So we pray and make dua that Allah give you and me the strength to turn to Him, to make that dua and prayers for those whom have left the dunya. Man matav, his qiyamah has begun. For you and I, we do not know in what condition we are going to leave the dunya. So we have to ask Allah Ta'ala to give us and bless us with husnal khatima. When we received that there was one alim and scholar who passed away in South Africa, he was in his salah and they said he passed away in the second rak'at while he was in sajda. And this is the people, this is the condition of a person, you know, when we say husn al-khatima. So when we leave the dunya, we want to leave the dunya on the good ending. Let's understand the importance and value of our masajid. Let's try and keep connection with the house of Allah. Let's make dua that Allah Ta'ala remove from us this pandemic and this virus and protect us all and all those who are ill and sick. Allah Ta'ala grant them shifa. All those who have passed away, Allah grant them maghfira. Until my next reflection program, remember me, Suleiman Ghani, in your duas. Assalamu alaikum wa rahmatullahi wa barakatuhu.